Today's topic is controversial. Women age faster. Is it a myth? Before we begin, I want to emphasize that this episode is not about dividing people by gender or implying that one group is superior to another. My focus is purely scientific, though I will consider societal influences. And my goal is to explore the evidence objectively. For the last year, I have been sharing animated science videos on this channel. But for this one, I'm trying something new. I am Lama, and I am a science storyteller. Or Hebe or Hebe was the goddess of youth in ancient Greek mythology, known for her beauty and immortality. People admired her for looking young forever. But what if she started showing signs of getting older? The belief that women age faster than men has deep roots in history. Ancient Greeks and Romans placed a high value on female youth and beauty. In Greek mythology, goddesses were often depicted as eternally youthful, and Roman society emphasized the importance of women maintaining their beauty to secure advantageous marriages and social status. These historical pressures have perpetuated the idea that women must remain young-looking, leading us today to perceive that women age faster when they show signs of aging. But it's not only history. Scientifically speaking, many studies have looked at health and aging, using gender as one of the factors. These studies often notice differences between men and women, even if their primary goal wasn't to compare genders. Let's take an example. A study on muscle loss found that men over 60 generally experience more severe muscle decline than women in the same age group. Research shows that women, especially after menopause, face a higher risk of fractures due to greater bone density loss and hormonal changes. On the other hand, a study funded by the National Institute on Aging compared how men and women experience cognitive aging. It found that men often face quicker declines in mental status and spatial skills, while women generally handle this better. However, this study also points out that societal factors may play a role in these differences, not just biological ones. Now we're talking. This has been shown to be true. While biology is definitely important, but how we live and our surroundings also greatly affect how we age. It isn't only about growing older, but about active aging. Definition time! The World Health Organization describes active aging as making the most of your health, staying involved, and feeling safe as you age. It means keeping active and engaged in life, even if your body changes. The number of people aged 60 and over is growing faster than any other age group. By 2050, the global population of people aged 60 and over will surpass 2 billion. This means we'll have more older people than younger ones. So, is it fair to always expect people to look young as they age? Shouldn't we embrace aging and appreciate the process? After all, not everyone gets the chance to age.
There's your movie.
There's a concept called intersectionality, created by Kimberly Crenshaw in 1989, that makes us realize how different parts of who we are, like our gender, ethnicity, and where we stand economically, intersect and influence our experiences. This means that how we age is not just about gender alone. For women, societal pressures to look youthful can be compounded by factors like race, economic status, and caregiving responsibilities, which mostly fall on women. These combined factors can affect how women experience aging compared to men. So even if studies suggest that women might age faster, this finding doesn't tell the whole story. But if we apply the intersectionality concept, we will find that there are many layers to aging that are shaped by overlapping social factors. For example, women might face greater challenges in accessing healthcare, job opportunities, and support systems, which can impact their health and aging process in complex ways. The World Health Organization's data shows that these inequalities are significant and real. To truly address these issues, we need to focus on the broader social inequalities that influence aging. It's not just about comparing who ages faster. It's about tackling the systemic factors that affect everyone's ability to age well, ensuring that all individuals, regardless of their gender, social status, and economy, have equitable opportunities for a healthy and active aging process. Aging is undeniably complex and different for everyone. But before we say women age faster or men, we still face significant questions. Have we accounted for all the factors influencing aging? Are our studies inclusive of diverse populations? How do societal perceptions align with scientific findings? For example, if research were to show that women age faster, how might this influence public discourse and policy? As for whether that women age faster is a myth or reality, that remains an open question for future research to explore. Thanks so much for watching. A lot of people who enjoy my videos aren't subscribed yet. So if you liked this one, I'd love it if you could hit the subscribe button and like this video. Your support means a lot and helps me keep creating videos like this one.